Hi, my name is Dr. Eric Beyer, and I'm a cardiothoracic surgeon in South Florida. I live in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and this is my daily coronavirus update. Today's date is the 19th of March, 2020. The total number of cases in the United States that have been diagnosed so far is 9,464. 205 of those cases came in the past 24 hours. There's been a total of 155 deaths in the United States, with five of those taking place in the last 24 hours. Here in South Florida, in Broward County in particular, there's been over 80 diagnosed cases. And in Dade County, which is just to the south of us, there's been over 75 diagnosed cases. I know of one recent death. That was a 70-year-old man that was at a nursing home off of West Commercial Boulevard. It was called Willow Woods. And he was confirmed diagnosed with coronavirus. There were two other folks living in that same nursing home that died, and they tested negative for the coronavirus. So as far as testing is concerned, here in South Florida, I know in Weston, they're ramping up some drive-through testing that's going to take place. And then in Pembroke Pines, I hear they're also going to have some drive-through testing. I'll give you updates on those. They're not open as of yet, but I'll get some more updates for tomorrow's update. With those testings, by the way, we're going to see a larger number of patients that have been diagnosed with coronavirus. I think it's super important we get these tests done. We need to get a handle on how many people have this disease, you know, what it's doing. Some people have very mild symptoms. Some people have severe symptoms and are hospitalized, put in ICU beds. So it's super important we get that number. Again, the symptoms are shortness of breath, cough, and fever. This is a virus that attacks your lungs. The coronavirus is a RNA virus that attacks your lungs and causes damage to the lung tissue that prevents the gas exchange that needs to take place between the blood and the air. And then you become hypoxic, and that makes you short of breath. You are short of breath, and that is a main symptom of this coronavirus. So it's important to recognize that. It's also super important to keep our social distancing. It's a kind of a catchphrase that's being used, but we have to adhere to what the government's asking us to do. I know in Hong Kong, they've mitigated a lot of the problems from the coronavirus because they have instituted the social distancing and also kind of hunkering down at home until this virus passes. And so it's important that we try to prevent the surge in patients coming to the hospital, that inundate the hospital systems, and then this is what causes increased mortality in patients, because if we have a big influx of patients coming to the ICU that need ventilators, and then we use up all of the resources, then the next wave of patients don't have those resources. So if we can flatten out that spike by staying at home, and if you can, and keeping your distance, it's going to be super important to prevent the spread of this very contagious virus. Also, wash your hands and go to my YouTube website. We're going to try to do some coronavirus videos so that we can talk a little bit more in depth about what the virus is doing and go from there. But we'll give another update tomorrow, and everybody stay safe.